This new circle setup here is going to be an experiment, a tryout for this spiral pattern. I just need to install all the drippers. I've got about 100 plus drip emitters here, and they all need to be put in using this tool, little punch, and then pushing the emitter in. If you do it without the punch, your fingers will only do about 20 of them before you give up. I can already hear Steve asking in the comments, what are we planning on growing here? We don't want the soil to get all fried up by the sun, so I'm going to get something in here as quick as possible. So I think what we'll do is we'll start at each drip emitter with a little guild. We can harvest some of the stuff for us, whether it be pumpkins or beans or radishes or whatever it is, and the surplus roots and tops can go to the animals. As I go around with the drip emitter installations, I'll balance out the rows. So if you know the spacing you want, you know the number of turns that you want, you put that in there, you can work it out, and it'll tell you how much pipe you need. Must say, mine did work out to less than 100 meters. I thought it didn't sound right. Started unrolling this and I was short about 20 or 30 meters of pipe. So this entire length is about 130 meters, but that means that we have a bed, a garden bed, that's 130 meters long here. So let's start from the top. When we talk about water quality, we have different meanings for different contexts. The first one is, of course, the water quality for your plants. This is important, yes, but it is not the primary concern of this video. What I'm concerned about is the quality of water that affects the equipment, the pumps, the systems, the plumbing. And our well water has quite a high level of calcium carbonate. And this is the same stuff that chalk is made of, board chalk. It's harmless, but it brings up the pH to a higher level than you want. So I've got this white gunk precipitating everywhere on the pipes, and these could clog emitters. And I've seen this in the shower head as well. They do clog some of the holes and they need manual intervention from time to time. So this is my primary concern. Now, many growers solve this by adding nitric acid or citric acid or muriatic acid, that's hydrochloric acid, pool acid, same thing, or sulfuric acid. And I've been thinking about this from two angles. One angle is adding sulfuric acid has the added benefit of improving the water on an agronomic level for the plants and soil, because it provides sulfur to the soil and to the plants, which is a much needed element. But on the other side, it will probably mean that you will need to constantly add amendments and spend money and do extra things. So I'll do a video about this in the future, but for now I think the best solution might be to add something like elemental sulfur to the JLF, to the liquid fertilizer that we make ourselves. So it's a targeted fertilizer, and it's fermented here at home, and then we can add elemental sulfur powder in there and acidify the water and then irrigate with it and still get the same benefits of adding sulfur to the soil and getting the pH to a much more normal level. This is going to take some research and trial and error, and I'm not really sure how to go about this. We'll take it on a bit by bit. Another important thing to consider as a prevention for clogging your emitters is to make sure that you have some kind of filter system on the line before the water gets to your drippers. For one, I've got a disc filter here. They are quite effective and efficient, and they are also back flushable, makes it quite a lot easier to maintain, and they don't rupture as easily as a mesh or screen filter. But whatever you put on there is better than nothing. To test your incoming water rate, your flow rate, you can do something like the bucket test. Shove the pipe in there from your main source and you fill a bucket with a known quantity of 10 or 20 liters, and you time it and from there you can work out your liters per minute or your liters per hour, and then consider the length of your pipe and all these things. These are important. Lastly, you can add something like an air valve somewhere in the system on the high side of the system to facilitate the water filling the pipes and get the water spread through the grid quicker, but also helps with water hammer, mitigates water hammer a bit. And I haven't done that yet, but I'm definitely going to do that, because I can see that on the far and lower end the emitters start flowing at least 20 seconds after the first emitters here on the line starts flowing. Okay, so I hope that was informative enough. I want to say thank you to everyone who watched the channel, as well as a special thanks to the Patreon crew. These guys make it possible and worthwhile and rewarding for me to do the videos in the heat like this. Makes it a pleasure to do. So thank you very much. And if you like dripper systems, then click the thumbs up button.